Are mona ubuka Johannes chapter 8.
I want to read what you know, listen very carefully.
Ina kona ke bale ntwe itse ba ni tshele jaho.
But Jesus, verse 1, went to the Mount of Olives early in the morning. He came back into the temple court, and all the people were coming to him. He sat and began teaching them. Now, the scribes and Pharisees brought a woman who had been caught in adultery. They made her stand in the center of the court, and they were said to him, "Teacher, this woman has been caught in the very act of adultery. Now, in the law, Moses commanded us to stone such woman to death. So, what do you say?" They said to this to test him, hoping that they would have grounds for accusing him. But Jesus stooped down and began writing on the ground with his finger. However, when they persisted in questioning him, he straightened up and said, "He who is without any sin among you, let him be the first to throw a stone at her head." Then he stooped down again and started writing on the ground. They listened and they began to go out one by one, starting with the oldest ones, until he was left alone with the woman standing therefore before him in the center of the court. Straightening up, Jesus said to the woman, "Did no one condemn you?" She answered, "No one, Lord." And Jesus said, "I do not condemn you either. Go. From now on, sin no more." Let's pray. Thank you, Lord, for your word. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Like I said, I was having questions. Asking God, what can I teach you before I pray for you? Because you had many teachings. And I had this story, which I want to share with you about this story. This story we have read here, you all know this story. But it's not talking about Jesus trying to prove that they are all sinners.
No.
Jesus, when he stooped down, he was checking
how
he can save the woman. He was checking if there's still more grace of making this woman to escape their threat. But after that, he realized that even if he saved this woman, this woman can still be caught again. It's better he say, "Go." But he gave this last message, "Say no more." I want to talk about this. No more.
No
more. No more. If you read that, you will realize that it is true, she was found with sin. But the reason why she was supposed to be judged, and Jesus to be judged for judging wrongly, was because she could not do adultery alone. In fact, They were supposed to have put Jesus in a position of judging the woman. But later they come and say, it's Jesus who said you must do this. And they will say, okay, tell us also why you say she committed adultery. Show us the man. There were a lot of things that were supposed to put Jesus on the
track.
But when Jesus looked down, he saw all the traps. And he sent the woman. But he said, from now on, stop sinning. As you are going, don't sin again. I want to talk about that. Can I tell you this?
Sin.
To do it is not wrong. I want to tell you about that. To commit sin. It's wrong only when you know the truth. Everybody can still do it and give you reason why they done
it.
Your judgment comes after you've done when you know. I found that all the punishments that they come to us, it's after we know and we carry on committing. The church today is comprised with people who are empty and who know the truth, but they continue sinning. Jesus said, I say, go. Stop sinning. Because he knows if she carry on, the worst will come. Can you ask your neighbor, say, my friend, you know the truth. And how far with the truth? Listen, it will be easy in the last day. You won't be judged by what you don't know. You'll be judged by what you know. The question is, why do you know this?
Why would you not have a chip?
You see, we have choice.
We decide.
And we end up putting ourselves in judgment. Can I tell you this? The reason why I said go and see no more, I'm not protecting what you have done. What you have done, as you can still do it, I'm saying to you, even if there is no condemnation, even if when you wake up you find there's no one who says you have done wrong, you need to check yourself if you are not sinning or not. Listen to this. Many times we justify ourselves because there's no one who can tell us we are wrong. Jesus said, go. But your assignment, stop sinning. Because the worst will come. If we read John 5, you read verse 14.
Verse 14.
When the man that was crippled, sleeping there for years, 38 years. And the Bible says, when Jesus looked on him, he saw why he slept there. And there was no one who can help him. And the Bible shows that the reason why is what Jesus addressed. He said, hey, go and see no more. Maybe that you have slept there because of sin.
Why don't want me to talk about
voice?
Because there's no
outside.
is a chain.
Si vina ki ketani.
Is a chain.
Ki ketani.
That sin is a chain.
Ketani ni se na
ketani. We need to break it today. Of the
go to therapy.
Yes, I am. The reason why you are sinning
is because
you what happened to you in the past.
Ke taba ya ntho e ke tsho ngwana gana.
Your past is haunting you.
Taba tsa ka khale go setse morao.
Somebody hurt you, you are angry.
Motho o mo wa tshitse o patelela ya
ga. Don't rejoice.
A gona go thaba.
You cannot do what is wrong.
A gona go tla ntshata tumbo.
Because of the
past. Go thata gore motho o tshitse mphogana.
Your message is.
Mola tsa wa wa shu.
Go.
Sepina.
And sin.
O se ka tola tla sin.
The last scripture we close.
Ere ke le tsena wa mama fela go tswana
go se you say I didn't read the Bible.
Tala tala ke bana ba ile.
Proverbs 22 verse 3.
Ye ba tedi tshofa re.
A prudent and far-sighted person sees his mystery, the evil of sin, and hides himself from it.
Amen.
But the naive continue on and are punished by the consequences of sin.
Amen.
Can you see the verse?
Hey, what are we saying?
I'm reading it
again.
He says, a prudent
Moshali.
And far-sighted person sees the evil of sin and hides himself from it. But the naive continue on
bafita
and are punished
by yohlaka
by the consequences of sin.
Amen.
Look at this, Hebrews 10 verse 26.
Bible 10.
If we go on willingly and deliberately after we receive the knowledge of the truth, there is no longer remains a sacrifice.
Amen.
To atone for our sins.
Amen.
No further offering to participate.
Amen.
Can you see that verse there?
Hey, what am I saying?
This shows that
the same one shall be.
Once we know the truth,
how do you have to teach?
For us to repeat the same thing.
What are we being happy and push it up to so great?
We cannot see far.
I don't want to go home.
We cannot see far.
I don't want to go home.
Do you know what blindfolders is?
They are the one enjoying the chapter about the same.
The reason why you can't see what will happen is your justification. Whereas there are hidden things. God is bringing light for you to see. When you see evil,
how
you hide.
Now I feel that.
When other people are killing,
how much trouble will I join me? Because I don't care about
you.
Listen.
Do you know what brought judgment in the house of
Jacob? Yes, I'm only giving you this. I have to look around.
He carry on.
When I join me, I say,
he knew.
That's him.
That one is the wife of Uriah.
Or almost are you like Uriah? So why?
He called the woman. He slept with him. And from there, it could not change. When he heard that she conceived, he carried on and called Uriah from the bedroom. When he sees Uriah, not accept
it.
Go to the
world.
God was watching to kill your
dear.
You know the truth.
That's
a judgment came. Rebellious children started to lose.
You
know the truth.
What's about Teresa again?
Why are you killing all?
I don't know why would you not be in the city?
You know this man.
What's he wrong?
It's not your husband.
That's why.
You know.
What's he wrong?
You are not married.
Or I'm so young.
What are you doing?
Nono mudi achelisi.
You know the truth, but you are carrying on. Your activity in the church is useless.
When now
what for challenge?
Just
we end up on our pastor. But we don't go beyond our pastor.
I finish.
You're blindfolded. If you can see far, you say, Pastor, sorry, I don't want to be an usher. Because I'm doing
this.
But you carry on. That pastor is praying for you. God bless you, but you carry on. Very soon you'll be exposed. Continue to see. I'll tell you what is there. It's stubbornness. Stubbornness is rebellion. Rebellion is to create an enmity with God. Be careful that you don't find God.